Hi, I'm Lieutenant Todd Gordon. I'm with St. Petersburg Fire and Rescue. We're here at Pierce Manufacturing to do the final inspection of our new 2025 Velocity Heavy Duty Rescue, Hazmat 5 to us. This unit will be located in downtown St. Petersburg at the Master Fire Station. I'd like to give you a walk around tour of Hazmat 5. So Hazmat 5 is a 84-inch cab extended, 20-inch raised command cab, and it's a 100-inch wide body and a 100-inch wide cab. Some of the features that we've added to this is we put HDMI output inputs on the side of the truck so that we can have TV monitors outside this unit, also with the TVs that are located inside. We went with the large command cab because obviously this is gonna be a research area for our hazmat team, so we're gonna need an extra headspace. So we went as big as we could on the cab. This is the largest that Pierce does offer us. We chose to go with the pneumatic fold-down steps just for better ease of access, because it does get a little cumbersome in there with the two forward-facing command chairs. Right now, the truck is completely off. It's being powered by a 20,000 kW diesel generator. It's running two Cummins Mach 8 AC units. They're about 15,000 BTUs, so it keeps it nice and cool in there. Also in the body, we incorporated a large command area. It's got two forward-facing chairs and an 8-foot slide out, and it extends out about 3 feet. We'll see that on the other side of the truck.
Hey, so one of the greatest tools we have for St. Pete Fire Rescue is our Drone 5. With the screens that we do have, we got 5 interior, 2 exterior. For the command aspect, we can get almost a overseas view of the scene. Also research if you can look for placards downrange. We got 2 exterior TVs which are ready for our second incoming entry teams, third incoming entry teams in our RIP. We can also switch into thermal if we need to. So if we're downrange, you can see all the heat signatures on the screen and let our crews know downrange what's obviously hot and or cold. But yeah, this is great. Great tool, great unit to have. Now having all the screens, it's great. For the county, we have a total of 5, so we can also tap into 5 other drones in our county, so everyone can jump on a screen and we actually get mostly a full view of the incident.
This is the 8-foot slide out, so it just gives us extra space so we can actually put more chairs in here and more people. We went with obviously more C-Tech storage. And we went with 2 24-inch Jensen high-definition smart TVs. Those are all linked up to the high-definition HDMI points. It's all connected with a 16x16 switcher. We went with obviously more just storage between the two. So this whole panel here is all dry erase. C-Tech, these surfaces are also considered dry erase so that we can actually write on here. We have a slide-out workstation. We do carry medicines that do have to be refrigerated. We do have a freezer, and we do have a refrigerator. So these right now, these are actually fans because the Cummins ACs will be running 24/7 while it's in the station. These are so we can climate control these front compartments, and that's where we're gonna keep, you know, we'll have medications that need to be stay cool, and then also our level A suits in the state of Florida, it's hot, so they actually will break down and deteriorate, so this is a way that we can kinda climate control these compartments. All right, over here, we have all of our electronics, so this is where we're gonna get all of our internet. Coming in through here, we have DVR recorders, Roku, we have that 16x16 switcher. So this is kind of like the brains of the command portion. We do have 3 TVs. They're all also smart high definition TVs. We also have this display that we can switch all of our switchers to whatever HDMI port that we need to use. The switcher then can switch to anything, to whatever TV screen we want to go to. That is the control for the 35-foot Viper camera.
So this is going to be our research area. On the way to calls, we'll be able to sit up here, we'll have computers on the monitors, we'll also be able to pull up the chemicals, do our research. Right now we have the 3 screens on 3 different things. One's on the drone that you just saw back there. We have this, our Speco NVR HD camera, focused in on a fire truck. Right now we can read the lettering clearly. We'll be able to see anything downrange. We couldn't find placards, stuff like that. And just to give you a reference of how far it keeps us away from the scene to get a recon, that's where we're at. And on our third screen over here, we have our 360 cameras that we have on around the truck. It's kind of nice that we'll be able to see what the crews are doing outside. If they need anything else from inside, we can be able to communicate with them like that.
And also, this is going to be for a lot of our electronics that and meters that need to be kept on a charger. We also put slots in it, so it is going to stay ventilated and nice and cool. We went with C-Tech tool chests in here. We went with all slide master tool slide outs. Yeah, tilt downs are rated at 250 pounds. We went with slide master tool boards. They're each rated at 1,000 pounds. Here we added in the coffin area, we added a 350 pound hopper for oil, our oil dry hopper. And then we have an access chute right here where we just put a 5 gallon bucket under there, and then we have a large supply of absorbent for any type of spill. We went with just a custom selection of poly boxes. We went with 150 cord reel. It actually has the four roller guide and extends out so that it can go around, easy access around the truck. We went with the 35 foot camera. It's a high definition Viper camera. We were at Lambeau Field yesterday and we were approximately more than 1,000 feet away from one of the Lambeau signs and we could read it with no problems. There here we put large slide master slides out. We chose to go with the retractable stairway. This gave us full complement of the back of the body. And we figured it was safety for our crew that they can go up inside, access the coffins, bring stuff down safely. We did go with both double awnings. They're lighted on each side. They're full electric. Yeah, we just went with more 1,000 pound slide outs just for extra storage. Another cord reel here. Like I said, we got recessed awnings and they are lighted. Just the other side of the tool boards. We also have C-Tech tool chests on this side of the vehicle. So we have some slide out tilt down trays. This is the 8 foot by 3 foot slide out for the command area. This compartment and actually the other compartments on each side, they're actually when the vehicle's in the station, it will be on shore power. It'll be running the Coleman ACs 24/7. These compartments here will actually carry our level A hazmat suits and they have to be climate controlled. So these compartments are actually AC'd through the body and through the cab.
All right, so here what we have is our exterior ports. We have our input and output and our networks. We have multiple tripods that we can plant our TVs on. Those are used for our interior and exterior teams when we have a drone in flight to visually look at what's downrange.
So we went with the 26 inch underslung bumper so we didn't have the frame rails that came through it. Gave us maximum storage space under here. We did compartmentize it and we went with the 8 inch raised cover. All right, well, thank you for doing this walk around tour with us. I would like to say thank you to 10-8 and Dustin Bauer for helping us put this truck together. Also, all my administrators in the City of St. Petersburg Fire Rescue, the hazmat team, all the individuals on our vehicle specification committee that helped assist putting this vehicle together. It was quite the process, but I think it's gonna be a real good asset in our city and can't wait to get it there. So thank you for watching.